this is just a recording on my phone, but this is where we've come to do our survival. Some bushcraft in the snow for 3 days.
Awesome.
Yeah, buddy. Okay, so we're starting fire in the snow today, and obviously as everything's very damp and wet, first thing we did was put up our shelter, which is really dodgy. It was just a quick line, a couple little things, and then started to get as much dry sort of tinder and kindling and all the rest as we could. So it's best found under these rocks over there, you can see, because obviously it hasn't been touched by the rain, so you know, just munch that up as best as you can so it's as fine as possible. It'll take a lot easier, and then you've got a lot of little dry stuff here that's processed, and then it just gradually gets bigger and bigger, which we'll get to. But you know, we've got a bunch of stuff around us, but first we need to get something going so that we can dry the rest of the stuff off, because most of it is wet. So anyway, see how this goes. This is all rock here, and there's actually rock on the bottom. As you can see, a bit of snow is coming through, but I think we'll still be able to get it going. So I might just get myself something to put this on. I'm a dragon. We had quite a bit of wet stuff before, but if I keep the heat underneath, it'll just, you know, as you can hear, it sizzling. So just a quick thing about fire placement. We're sort of down in a bit of a gully here, with some, we've got that rock that acts as a reflector and also protects us from the wind. We've got our very dodgy shelter that's only temporary to keep the camera gear and other shit dry for the minute, and then I'm going to start working on this shelter and do all the other things we got to do and make some lunch. And the first thing was shelter and then fire, so that was our priority. And later on we'll go through what we're wearing, why we're wearing it, you know, cryptic stuff, but I'll get to that. And yeah, just basic self-maintenance, you know, maintaining body temperature, fluids, and the priorities of survival. So stay with us. Okay, so as you can see, I've moved the fire from here to here. Seemed easier to manage. Also remembered that putting a fire on wet rock can make it explode in some cases. I'm not really 100% sure what type of rock that is, so you know, I just moved it down here for the time being, and you know, got some reflectors going. I'm gonna clean it all up for melting some snow for some water. And I've got a barbecue wire thing I'm going to put down to make some meat soon. So it's a little update. And this is the best position. This is probably the best position to smoke. I've been going out that way, but yeah, now I'm going to get back to cleaning up the shelter and doing what else we got to do. So, but all in all, it's working out pretty well. So again, just managing those, again, just getting a decent flame at the bottom so then we can put wet stuff on top and just sort of have it dry out, you know, and managing it And my kid's off getting bigger pieces of fire. So you start off, you know, obviously I think I've said this before, but you know, as small as possible, make your bird's nest, and then something as thick as your finger, your pinky finger, then maybe your thumb, then your wrist, and then your forearm sort of thing. Can build it up depending on how big you want it. So, all right. It's got some, what do we call it, yakiniku here, some steaks, some cut up steaks on the barbie. And for any of you Yanks out there, there's obviously Poms and Aussies know this, but you never actually say shrimp on the barbie. No one fucking says that. So yeah, whenever you say that to an Aussie, it's usually a face palm sort of reaction. But anyway, we're having a bit of steak, bit of steak brew. There we go. Out here in a lovely bush. Got some steak sauce coming. Got some veggies as well. Fucking grouse. Alright. I'm gonna keep collecting this, and as I said, just processing this shit like a fucking alpha as fuck. Basically. And then